Hallelujah. Welcome to church tonight. Amen. We're going to pray and we're going to believe God for great and mighty things tonight. Amen. So bow your heads and your hearts tonight. Father, we thank you for such a beautiful, beautiful presence. Lord, the anointing of your Holy Spirit, Father God, is in this place.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you, Father God, that you, Father, have cleansed us. You've washed us in your precious blood, Lord. You've allowed us to enter into the gates of worship and of praise tonight, Lord. We ask right now, Holy Spirit, that you would come, have your way, work in us, and minister to us, Lord. Let the worship and the praises of our mouth, Father God, exit this building and enter into the Holy of Holies, Lord. We set ourselves aside, our will, our purpose, our own agendas, Lord, and we ask that you would come and that you would fill us with your strength, your peace, and your glory. We thank you in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah, church. Worship with us. Amen tonight. Hallelujah.
Come on, let's put our hands together. Worship the Lord tonight. Oh, I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight?
Yeah.
It was my tomb till I met you. Thank you.
God that He is a God that keeps drawing us closer to Him.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says that if we draw near to Him, then He will draw near to us. You know, sometimes in life, we forget our first love. We get caught up with so many things in this world. We get distracted so easily. But tonight, God says, just come back to me. Just sit at my feet and worship me. I'm Somebody give the Lord a shout of praise.
In the offering, amen. So we encourage you to continue, amen, sowing, continue believing, and continue trusting in the Lord, amen. And tonight, if you need an envelope, just raise your hand, and our brother will be more than happy to serve you this evening, amen. And we are so excited, amen. The Lord is continuing to show his greatness, his faithfulness, amen, and his promise to us as a people of God, amen. And so we encourage you tonight, amen, to be encouraged, to be motivated, to be, let your fire be stirred up inside of you, amen. Because God is doing fresh and new things in his house, amen. And so we are so grateful and thankful for you. Those of you that watch us online, amen, we welcome you tonight, and we encourage you to stay with us, amen, throughout the service, amen, tonight, because you will be blessed, you will be encouraged, you will be uplifted through the presence and the power of God's word, amen, tonight. We want to remind you that on October 29th, as we've been announcing, amen, we will be hosting, amen, a family community outreach here at Livingstone Family Church from 11 to 2. We want to offer our community, amen, free drinks, amen, water, free sodas, free food, amen. We're excited because we're making these plans, amen, and we know that the Lord is going to supply every need that we have,
amen,
as a church and as a body of Christ. And we're going to be out here in our parking lot, amen. We're going to be just sharing the love of Jesus,
amen.
We love everything. We're going to be sharing God's love, amen, to our community and letting them know that we also are here, amen, to encourage them and let them know that there is a God of hope in this time, in this season of their lives, amen.
Hallelujah.
And so we're going to pray and believe, amen. We are continuing to receive. I think we've pretty much covered most of the donations, amen. If you haven't already signed up, we do have a sign-up sheet that we have already started. The main thing I believe is we're just needing more cases of water, amen, more cases of bottled water. So those of you that are able to, amen, to bring those in, you can bring them in at any time, amen, before the 29th or even on the 29th. We'd like to have them, you know, cold and ready and available for that that morning.
Amen.
And be ready for the people, amen, as we minister to them and as we bless them, amen, on behalf of our church family here. We also just want to continue to encourage you, amen, to stay faithful, stay strong, amen. Shifting is happening, amen, and we are not shaken, amen.
That's right.
But we are standing on the foundation of the truth of Jesus Christ,
amen,
who is our Lord and our Savior.
Yes,
so just put your eyes on God.
Amen.
Put your eyes on Jesus. Let's take our eyes off of man.
Yeah.
And man will always fail us, amen, and sometimes even betray us whenever we're thinking that good things are ahead, amen. Sometimes you're blindsided, amen. And so we just know without a shadow of a doubt that God is forever faithful.
Yes, he is.
Forever it remains the same. Though things may shift in our lives, seasons may come and go, we know that he remains faithful and true. And so we stand on that, amen, tonight. Let us pray for your seed. Father, we thank you. Lord, you have been so faithful to us, not only as individuals and as family, Father, but you have been so faithful to us, Lord God, as a church and as a community. Lord, we thank you, Father God, for those that have remained strong in you, Father, that have not wavered to the right or to the left, Father God. Lord, but we have continued steadfastly in your promises, in your word, in what you have given to us to uphold, Father God, before you, Lord. So we run with the baton of faith.
Yes.
Lord, we run this race, Father God, not trying to beat anyone out, but we run steadily and at a pace that you have allowed us to run at, Father God. But we say right now, Lord, that we declare it with our mouth, Lord God, that every good thing comes from above, Father. And though there are things in our lives that are removed, that are taken away, Father God, for unannounced reasons that we don't know about, we can trust that you will remain faithful and you will replenish those things that need to be replenished in your house, Father God. So we thank you tonight for well-enabled believers of God who trust you with their seed this evening, Lord. Multiply, bless, open up windows, Father, that no man enclosed windows that no man can open, Father. We trust you with the seed of faith that we are sowing to your kingdom tonight. It's in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray and believe. Amen and amen. Hallelujah, church. Come on up tonight and give cheerfully to the Lord.
Come and know that everything's going to be all right. Because we're in the Lord's hands. There's a day that can silence or whatever we feel. There's a love that embraces the heartache, the pain, and the tears. Through my faith in my God, I know one thing's for sure. His word is we'll be right back.
just want to encourage you, amen, to continue praying, continue believing God, amen, for great and mighty things,
amen,
in this local house, amen.
That's right.
Because God is doing something great, amen, and we want to be a part of that. Hallelujah. So with us tonight, amen, to bring us the word of the Lord, Pastor Mark Mata. Let's give God one more praise.
The house of the Lord. How about you?
Hallelujah, that's right.
I'm glad that I'm saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Praise God. God. As I was singing that song just a while ago, I really believe the Lord wants us to know tonight. Todo va a estar bien.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen. That's
praise
right.
God. It is. Amen. That's right.
You know, no matter what we face in life, things change and you know, fads change, trends change, people come, people go, but
amen.
God's word is forever settled in heaven.
Yep.
Yep. Amen.
Yep.
And so we just stand on the word of God. You got nothing else to stand but on the word.
Yeah.
You got everything.
Yeah.
I just want to encourage you tonight that Dolo,
that's right.
Everything is going to be right. All right. Well, if you have your Bibles, open it with me, please. To the book of Amos. We're going to go back to Amos as we were talking about it on Sunday.
Yeah.
And man, I just can't get this word out of my spirit.
Hallelujah.
That it really has to do with a life principle, what we've been talking about.
Yep.
The life principle of sowing and reaping. And we're learning, church, that we can never lose when we sow. We can never be defeated as believers if we continue to sow in the kingdom of God.
Yes.
No matter what we face, no matter what's going on. And so I want to share some thoughts that we didn't conclude with on last Wednesday regarding catching up with sowing. And tonight, I want to go to Amos again, 9, the book of Amos, chapter 9, church. And look at me, please, in verse 13. Amos 9:13. It says, "Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when the plowman, or we could call him the sower, shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of the grapes him who sowed seed." I'm just going to stop right there and just encourage you to let you know that you are not behind in the will of God. You are not in a place that you missed something from God. God knows what he's doing.
Yes, he does.
God doesn't make mistakes.
Amen. That's right.
And we've been learning that God knows how to accelerate the anointing of God on our lives.
Yes.
God knows how to accelerate us in the will of God.
Amen.
It's never too late to start seeking God.
That's right.
Amen. It's never too late to go after God. I don't care what your age is. I don't care what you've gone through.
That's right.
I don't care what battles you're facing.
Amen.
How many times you failed God.
Right.
Maybe even went through a season of backsliding.
Yeah.
Or giving up, almost gave up. And God nudged you back in the way.
Amen.
God brought you back to his saving grace and the plan. Because I'm going to tell you something. The Bible talks about little books in the book of Revelation that God spoke to John the Revelator. And God told him to open up those little books. Those books are the books of our destiny.
Amen.
The books of our future. And so it's never too late to open up those books.
That's right.
To begin to go after God with all your heart.
Amen.
And so I want to encourage you
that
it's never too late to start serving God.
That's right.
Amen.
Because God says, I'm going to allow what you're sowing right now, what you're doing right now, what you're planning right now is not in vain.
That's right.
You are going to overtake the reaper.
Yes.
What does that mean? That means that God, when he sees your heart, that you want him, when he sees your desire, your passion to go after him, guess what's going to happen? You're going to start growing. You're going to start making steps to be an effective, fruitful believer. Because remember, God doesn't want us just to be faithful, but he also wants us to be fruitful.
Yes.
And how do we become fruitful? We become fruitful when we keep sowing good seed.
Amen. That's right.
I'll share another scripture with you as we're going to jump start this message tonight. I want to talk about the four purposes of why we sow. The four purposes of sowing. But before we get into that, let's go again to this scripture that, man, it just blessed me this week as I read it. Hebrews chapter 6. Hebrews chapter 6. Now, in Hebrews chapter 6, we find these encouraging words that I want to encourage you with tonight, church. I want to strengthen you. I want to help you grow in the Lord tonight.
Amen.
So here we go. And this ministered to me. In fact, my wife shared the scripture with me, and she hardly ever sent scriptures to me. And she sent it to me the other day, I think it was Monday. And I just needed this word of encouragement. And I was going through something, and I know some of you are praying for me and praying for your church and praying for your fellow brothers and sisters in the Lord.
Yes.
And she sent this to me, and it really just ministered to me. Here it is. In Hebrews chapter 6, verse 10, for God is not unjust to forget your work and labor of love,
yes, sir,
which you have shown toward his name,
yes,
and that you have ministered to the saints, and you do right now minister.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Yes, amen.
You know, sometimes people don't appreciate you.
That's right.
Sometimes people don't value what God does in your life for them.
Mm. Right.
But God always takes note.
Yes, sir.
Of every seed that you sow.
That's right.
And he says, I am not going to forget. I'm not unjust.
Thank you, Lord.
We serve a good God, a mighty God.
Yes.
And we serve a God who's a just God.
Yes.
And you might not feel appreciated by people. People may not pat you on the back sometimes. People might walk out of your life.
That's right.
But guess what? God is keeping score of every seed that you have sown for his name, for his kingdom.
Hallelujah.
He sees
Hallelujah.
Our heart. Amen, church.
Thank you, Lord. Yes.
And when I read that this week, it just really ministered to me.
Man.
Because it reminded me that the Lord is keeping score.
Yes, he is.
And it reminded me that we just got to keep on sowing.
Yes.
And keep on doing good, no matter what we go through.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So tonight, I think this will bless you. I want to share with you the four purposes of sowing. Why do we sow? And just to remind you, what is a seed? Because we've been called by God to plant seeds.
Mm-hmm.
We've been called by God to be the plowman, as we read in Amos. And you know what was going on during that time? God raised up the prophet Amos to bring some strong words.
Mm-hmm.
Because the bulk of that book speaks of judgment, destruction coming. That God was going to bring judgment to the people of God because they had strayed away from the Lord. They strayed away from God's presence. But guess what? God said, but I'm going to restore. God promised that the end of that chapter, the end of that book in Amos, it ends not with a bleak, despair, gloom picture. But we have now a picture. We have a picture of God restoring. And that is also, I want you to understand, no matter, sometimes God judges us. Sometimes we go through seasons where we reap the consequences of bad things that we've done.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't mean that God doesn't love us.
That's right.
That doesn't mean that God's plan for us, it's not going to happen.
Yes, amen.
It doesn't mean that those books of your destiny are going to be closed forever.
That's right.
No, yes. It just means that God has to do a work in all of our lives.
Amen.
And so the thing that I love about Amos is he spoke a word of encouragement at the end. And he said that the land is going to be replaced. He said, your broken heart is going to be repaired.
Yeah.
He said, your prosperity is going to be renewed.
Amen.
And he also said something powerful. He said, your leadership is going to be restored.
Yes.
And I believe that that is a prophetic word for this hour, for this season.
Amen.
That God is restoring the leadership in our ministry, in our calling.
Amen.
I believe God is renewing prosperity.
Yes.
Amen. And I believe that God is healing the broken pieces of our heart and repairing our soul.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I believe that God is giving us land that has been misplaced. God's bringing us back to the land that flows with milk and honey.
Yes, thank you, Jesus. Yes.
But we got to keep plowing.
Amen.
We got to keep moving. We got to keep digging. Mm. You know, I like what your Bible says about Isaac. After he had failed God, like his father Abraham, he lied. Mm. He told the people that he was going to that wasn't his wife. Mm. Because he was scared. He was fearful.
Yeah.
And yet God told him, just keep digging. Mm. I'm going to bless you. I'm going to favor you. And he started digging another well. Started digging the well so that the blessing and the water of life would come back. Amen. But guess what? The Philistines got jealous. They envied him. Mm. And they stopped up those wells. That's what your Bible says. They stopped up the wells with dirt. That's what the enemy tries to do sometimes in our lives.
Yeah.
Stop the blessings of God.
Yeah.
He wants to hinder us. He wants to impede the work of God that he has for us,
yes.
That God has for us. Mm. And so, but it didn't stop Isaac. Mm. Isaac just said, that's all right. Let's keep digging.
Amen.
And they kept digging more wells. And God blessed them. Mm. And God favored them.
Amen.
And so let me encourage you tonight.
Yes.
Keep digging.
Yes, yes.
Keep going after God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
God is not unjust to forget your work and your labor of love.
Thank you, Lord. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, a seed. I want to say this before I give you the four purposes tonight of sowing. When I talk about sowing, what are we really talking about? What are we really challenging you to do when we talk about planting seed? I know you heard that. Probably repetitively, quite often, maybe you've heard it here in this church. We talk a lot about planting, sowing, giving.
Right.
But what does it really mean? Well, there's three ways that we give and we plant seed. We plant seed in regards to our time, in our talents,
right.
And in our treasure. Yeah. Everybody say time.
Time.
Everybody say talent.
Talent.
And everybody say treasure.
Treasure. Right.
That's how we sow. We sow when we give of our time.
Mm.
You know, a lot of people, they just are looking for someone to listen to.
Yeah.
There's a whole lot of people that are inconsiderate of people's feelings and their time. We're all, you know, it seems like we're all on a schedule. We're all, you know, going here, going there. But it does say something to you. Your walk with God, when you can take the time and spend time with people. You've heard me say that the way you spell love is T-I-M-E, time.
Yeah.
If you love your husband, you love your wife, you spend time with them.
Right.
If you love your children, guess what you do? You make that investment, you go to the games, you go to the ballparks, you help them if they need help at their school and their academics.
Mm.
You go to the presentations at school. I remember when my kids were little, And especially those that were going to Christian private school, I remember that they would have, you know, special award ceremonies.
Mm.
Even though I worked, and even though my wife worked, guess what? We called in and said, we're coming in to work late.
Amen.
Because we got to go to our son's, our daughter's ceremony.
Mm.
They're going to get a certificate. And it was sometimes 8, 9 o'clock in the morning. So guess what? We finished. Maybe afterwards, I remember my wife, then we go get a little breakfast taco, get something to eat, and then we went back to work.
Mm-hmm.
See, we made that investment.
Yes.
You need to make the time, make the investment.
Amen.
And then we also sow by our talents, our gifts. You know, all of us in this room tonight, all of us watching us, those of you watching me by Facebook and hearing this, you know, we've all been given different talents, different gifts of God.
Yes.
And what we do to that is our gift back to God.
Yes.
When we give our gift to God and we share what God has blessed us with, then we are sowing. We're sowing seeds.
Yeah.
We're giving of our time. We're giving of our gift, our talent. And then also, we give of our finances.
Amen.
We give financially to help people. You know, there's the way we do life today, the way we do business, you know, it takes money. It takes finances.
Right.
It takes, you know, cards, and we got to, you know, swipe. And I want to thank God for all of you here tonight and all of you that are watching us. I want to thank God for you that believe in this ministry so much so that you sow and you give financially to the kingdom of God.
Thank you
for that. so much. Now, we give of our time, we give of our talents, and then we give of our treasure. But listen to this. I'm going to ask if they can put it back. I think I have it on the notes from last week. A seed. What is a seed? Because that's what God's called us to do. Plant seeds.
Yeah.
Keep sowing. It's anything that you say, it's anything that you think, or anything that you do to benefit someone else.
Okay.
All right? So it's not all about money. Planting seed, doing good, it's not all about just giving somebody $20,
right,
paying their light bill.
Because
how many of you know that you can give without loving?
Yeah.
But you can't love without giving.
Yes.
Did y'all get that?
Yes.
You can give money out here, take it. You can throw a $5 dollar bill at that homeless person. You don't care nothing about him. Come on, somebody. You can just give to somebody so they stop harassing you and bothering you.
Yeah.
Remember one time we were at a restaurant having a good time. I think it was the Longhorn Steakhouse. And we were having a good time. We got to go there again, right, Johnny? And when we walked into to the front door, right in front of the front door, that patio area, whatever, the walk, sidewalk, was a little little tent they had, just a little booth. And they were asking donations for some kind of children's program, something like that. I can't remember what it was. But I remember the first time we were there, we were like, okay, we'll talk later. And so we came out and they were talking and talking, and I just felt like, okay, just, you know, you would like to give? We're trying to tell them no, and like, no, it's okay, I don't have it, but really, you can put it on your card and say, all right, here.
Yeah.
And so sometimes we do that, don't we?
Yeah.
Sometimes we just give people money so they'll just leave us alone.
Right.
Amen? All right. Yeah. I'll give you the $5. All right. You can take $5 out of my card. All right.
Yes.
But when you love someone,
yes,
guess what? Giving comes automatically.
Yeah. Yeah.
When you love someone, oh, I'm telling you, you can't stop giving.
Right. Amen.
See, when we love Jesus.
Yes.
And what we sang earlier, we're coming back to that first love.
Mm.
Coming back to intimacy with God. And you know how God defines intimacy? He says, it's into me. See? That's God's definition of intimacy.
Yeah.
It's into me. See?
Yes. Yes. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
The enemy tries so hard. And I'm exhibit A, I know.
Mm.
To distract us.
Yes,
he wants to distract our devotion from him.
Right. Yes, he does.
He doesn't want us to read our devotions every day.
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
He doesn't want us to pray and spend time with God.
That's right.
Amen. That's right.
The enemy doesn't want us to come to church
and
spend time. And I want to applaud you tonight. Some of you, it was an effort.
Yes.
But guess what?
Yes,
you love Jesus. You love God.
Yes.
Keep sowing.
Yes.
Glory to God.
So, four purposes of sowing. This is what the Lord gave me, and I think it'll bless you. Number one, we sow to grow.
Yes.
Now they're all going to kind of rhyme a little bit. I'm going to sound like a rapper tonight.
All right,
all right. We sow to grow. Why are we taking the time tonight and Sunday? Why are we sharing this message about sowing?
Yes.
Overtaking the reaper by our planting seeds and giving. Why? This is so important. Because that's how we grow.
Yes.
That's right. Yes. Yes. Amen.
We sow to grow.
Amen.
Galatians 6, 7 through 9. Let's go there. Galatians chapter 6, 7 through 9. We're going to read chapter 6 of Galatians. And you're all familiar with this. This is just kind of a reminder, because some of you I know are familiar with this. Verse 7, do not be deceived. God is not mocked.
Hmm.
How many know that we can fool people, but we can't fool God?
Amen, that's right.
Yep.
Well, I got to say that again. We can fool people, and people can fool us, but we can't fool God.
Amen.
Do not be deceived. God is not mocked.
That's right.
For whatever a man sows, he will also reap. That's called the law of sowing and reaping.
Yes,
for he who sows, verse 8, to the flesh, will of the flesh reap corruption.
Mm.
But he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life.
Yeah.
Look at verse 9. And let us not grow weary while doing good.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
For in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart.
Yes.
Amen.
God promises us that we are going to grow if we don't stop sowing.
Amen. That's right.
So we sow to grow.
Yes.
Don't lose heart, he says. Don't lose your passion for God. Just keep sowing. Just keep giving. Amen.
Amen. Yes.
If what you have in your hand does not meet your need, then it's a seed.
Amen. Yes.
What you have in your hand, in your bank account, your checking account, your savings account.
That's right.
And your resources. How many know that we are limited?
Yes.
But God is unlimited.
Yes.
I heard a preacher say one day, he said, you know why? If you read the book of Revelation, that there's no record of heaven having ceilings. He said, there's no record in the Bible. You can see that in heaven there's ceilings. You know why? Because God is unlimited.
Yes,
He is. Amen. Thank you. He's a God that does exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could even ask or think.
Yes, He is.
So we sow to grow. Say that with me. Say, I sow to grow.
I sow to grow.
Yes. Sowing, listen to this. This will help you. Sowing is emptying of your present so you can feel your future.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank
you.
Say it again. Sowing is emptying of your present so you can fill up your future.
Amen.
Good. Amen.
That's why we sow.
Yes.
We sow to grow.
Mm.
You know, I'm excited about not this Saturday, but the next Saturday, we're going to have an outreach.
Amen.
And, you know, we are thanking you and asking you bring gifts. And some of you have already donated water bottles and food and things of that nature. But, you know, we invested also a sign. We're going to put a banner, and it's in the, they're working at it at a sign company. And I was looking around and I said, well, Lord, you know, I know it's going to cost some money, but you know what? We're going to do it.
Amen.
Because what price can you put on one soul
coming
to faith in Jesus Christ?
Yeah. Yeah.
What price can you put?
Mm-hmm.
$1 million would be worth it.
Yeah.
$10 million would be worth it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we do things in this church, we're not perfect in what we do in the ministry.
That's right.
And we still got a lot to improve on.
Amen.
But when COVID-19 hit, we started our live stream ministry, and we invested in that. We pay a fee. If you don't know that, we pay a fee every month.
Mm-hmm.
You help us do that.
Amen.
When you sow, when you give your tithes and your offering, you help us every month to be a blessing to people that watch us on Facebook.
Amen.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
And this sign banner, you know, at first somebody was giving me one company was giving me a real high rate. And I said, you know, that just didn't sound right. So I went to another company and they said, we could do it for $60. I said, that's all, $60. And it's a huge banner, it's about like 94 by 34. And, but we're gonna put it right there on the corner in just a few days. They should be ready by Friday. And we're gonna have it out there.
Amen.
And we're gonna let people know there's a free event. And we're going to tell them about Jesus. We're going to tell them about the Lord.
Yes.
So we sow to grow.
Yes. Amen.
I want you to get that in your spirit. We are sowing people. We are giving people because that's how we grow.
Yeah.
You know, being generous and being greedy, all it is about choices.
Yeah.
It's a choice.
Yes.
And when you are generous and when you give, then you're conquering greed.
Yeah.
You're conquering selfishness.
Yeah. Right, that's right.
I mean, we all want our human nature without God,
right,
without the Lord. Our human nature is me, 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 me.
Yeah.
Yes, amen.
Right. So let me encourage you to understand, number one, the first purpose of sowing is we sow to grow. Number two, we sow when the circumstances say no. I'm trying to rhyme a little bit. We sow when the circumstances on the outside say, no, you better keep it. Better hold on to it. No. But let me show you what Ecclesiastes. Let's go there. Ecclesiastes 11:4. Isn't this good tonight, church?
Amen.
We need to learn that we got to be sowers. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Ecclesiastes, Old Testament. 11. Ecclesiastes 11:4. Ecclesiastes chapter 11 with verse number 4. Watch this. This is powerful. He who observes the wind will not sow, and he who regards the clouds will not reap.
Amen. That's right. Wow.
What is that scripture verse telling us? That if we look at the outside, at the natural, we look at our bank account, oh, I don't have enough to give. Oh, I don't have enough to bless somebody. If we look at the economy, well, you know, I don't know if I can do that and give to my church because, you know, the gas prices are going up or whatever is changing. No, don't look at that.
Right.
Don't let that be the spiritual barometer engage of your sowing level.
Right.
Don't look at that. See, we don't live by the economy of this world.
That's right.
We live by God's economy.
Yes.
We live by heaven's economy.
Yes.
There's no lack in heaven. I read in the Bible that heaven has streets of gold.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes.
Walls of jasper.
All right. Thank you.
Crystal sea. Mansions. Come on.
Yep.
There's nothing lacking in God's kingdom.
That's right. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
We just got to learn to trust Him.
Amen.
We just got to learn to believe God.
Yep. Amen.
A preacher one day was asked by the Lord, I believe it was Brother Jesse Duplantis, and the Lord told him one day, how would you like to have a new jet, a new airplane in your ministry? He already had one. He said, how would you like an upgrade? How would you like me to bless you with another one? He said, well, Lord, I don't know if I can afford it. He said, I didn't ask you to pay for it.
All right.
He said, can you believe that I can give it to you?
Amen.
Come on, church. We got to stretch our thinking a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
You don't have to pay for it.
Right.
I'm talking to somebody tonight.
Amen.
You're believing God for something and you think you got to pull it off.
Right.
You think you got to make it happen.
Right.
But the Bible says that He's our Jehovah Jireh. He's our provider. Amen. Glory to God.
Yes. Hallelujah.
He will provide everything that we need.
Yes.
You're sitting on some chairs that we didn't have to pay for. I say that not to get a big head. Man, we don't deserve it. But God does these things to let us know that He's in charge. He's large and in charge. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
This sanctuary walls were painted at no cost to us because a contractor came in here, tears in his eyes in my office, crying like a baby, said, I gotta give my tithe to you that I've been saving for a whole year because our church closed down in Uvalde, Texas. And when we went home, we couldn't believe it. We were crying at home. When we counted the offering, opened up the envelope, and it was over a $5,000 cashier's check.
Amen.
And not only that, he said, Pastor, can I paint your church? Can I paint the walls of the church? He was a painter. And I said, sure, but can you give me a quote? He said, no, I don't need a quote. You don't need a quote. I'm going to do it for free. God put it in my heart to do it for you, the church. All I need you to do is just do me a tax write-off so that I can claim it on my taxes for the end of the year.
Amen. Yes.
I said, we can do that.
Glory to God.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
I don't know again who I'm talking to tonight. Maybe you're not even here. Maybe you're watching me. Maybe you're hearing me on YouTube one day, or maybe you're going to go back home and maybe really get it. Because how many know sometimes we miss sometimes what God says?
Yeah.
And then we go back and say, well, I got it now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So whoever this is for, God put a dream in your heart. God put a vision in your heart. And you're looking at your bank account. You're looking at what you make an hour after they take out this, they take out that. Uncle Sam takes that out. Uncle Sam, you got your Medicare, and you take out, they take out the Medicare. Insurance is taken out. Sales tax. If I buy something at work and I don't pay for it, they take it out.
Yeah.
They just charge it to my account. I'm like, where'd that come from? The bistro. I don't remember. Oh, yeah, I remember I got a coffee at the bistro. And then they charged me for it. I thought, I didn't think she was going to charge me for it. I thought she was going to say, yeah, it's a free coffee. She said, I was asking, I'm wondering, like, why was she asking what my name was? But in this season of your life, there's going to be some things you don't have to pay for.
Yeah.
Now, don't let that be something that makes you cocky or arrogant or ungrateful.
Right.
Because I heard a minister say one time, they went into a restaurant. And they went in the restaurant, and a lady recognized him as a pastor, right? Said, oh, are you Pastor so-and-so? I think it was a waitress, right? And she saw him. He said, yes, I am. You're the one that has that church over there down the street? Yes, yes. You know, he didn't want it. He wasn't a type of guy that goes to the restaurant and says, I'm Bishop so-and-so. I'm Cardinal Mata. You know, I'm Archbishop Flores. No, he just wanted to go in there and have some chilaquiles plate, that's all. And she said, I'm going to bless you, she said. She said, I'm going to discount you. He said, no, I don't want that. He said, no, you're a pastor. You're a minister. You should be honored.
Amen.
He put his head down. He said, thank you, but I want to pay the full price of my meal.
Amen.
Now, I don't know how many of us would have taken the discount.
Right.
I don't know if I would have said that.
Right.
I would have said something like, you know, the Lord works in mysterious ways. You know,
yeah.
But he said why he didn't take the discount. You know why he didn't take the discount? Or even the free meal. I think she's going to pay for the meal. He said, because I want you to know I'm a true Christian. And I want to pay what I order.
Amen.
And not only that, I'm going to give you a good tip.
Right now.
I don't need something free. Now, I don't know if that's at your level. Maybe some of you are not there yet. But there might be moments where you may be challenged to do something that maybe God says, I don't really want you to do that. It's not wrong. It's not sinful. You know, you're not going to go to hell if you take the discount. Amen.
Right.
But maybe God's trying to teach some of us, if I pay the full price now, one day I'm going to reap a blessing that's going to be so powerful, so supernatural.
Yeah.
See, we might need the discount later on.
Yeah.
We might need something bigger later on. That's why I'm telling you to sow. Sow now, don't take the harvest yet, because one day you're going to get a bigger harvest.
Yes, yes, hallelujah.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Right now it's a season where, all right, I'm not supposed to reap it. I'm not supposed to get it just yet. Don't give me the discount yet. Now, maybe next week when I don't have no money, I might need that discount.
Yeah.
Or right now, I got the money. So here, be a blessing to somebody.
Amen.
So number two, we sow when the circumstances say no. I'll say one more thing and I'll move on to the last two. There will never, ever be a perfect time to sow. There'll never be a perfect time.
Yeah.
Get that out of your mind. Okay, well, when I get that big old bonus at work, when I get my bonus, my Christmas bonus, by the way, I'm getting my Christmas bonus coming this year. Then I'll give that extra money to that sound system. Then I'll give that extra money to that $60 sign.
Right.
You know, but not right now. Well, guess what? There's never a perfect time. One time, I had some money, and the Lord put it in my heart to give it to another ministry. And I said, Lord, but which one? Mm-hmm. You know, I love that ministry. I love that ministry. I mean, I watch a lot of Christian television. And I'm like, well, who do I bless? And I was waiting and waiting and waiting. And days had gone by. Finally, I heard a prayer. And the Lord speaking to my heart, what are you waiting on? Mm-hmm. I said, well, Lord, I don't know which one. He said, does it matter?
Right.
I heard the Lord say that.
Amen.
Just let it go. There's not a perfect ministry.
Right.
There's not a perfect time.
Right.
Just do it.
Amen.
Just give.
Amen.
That's how sowing should be. Just so natural.
Yeah.
That we just give automatically.
Yes. Amen.
I'm not talking about being taken advantage.
Right. Right.
I'm not talking about spoiling someone.
Yeah.
I'm talking about being a blessing. And don't look at your circumstances. Because
yeah,
if you look at the clouds, the Bible says in Ecclesiastes, if we observe the wind, we're not going to sow.
Yeah, right.
If we look at the clouds, we're not going to reap. So don't look at that. Look to the word. Number three, we sow to who we know.
Ooh,
like I said, I'm trying to rap tonight.
Yeah.
I'm trying to rhyme.
Got you.
We sow to who we know. Let me give you a story real quick. Genesis 47, 23. First book in your Bible. All right. Genesis 47 talks about a powerful man of God that had the favor of God over his life by the name of Joseph. But you know, before Joseph, God promoted him, as you know. He became second only in command to Pharaoh. But he was thrown in the pit by his brothers.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. If you can handle family,
yeah,
you can handle anything. I wish I had a witness on my life. Anybody had some brothers or sisters throw you in the pit? Delete you from their Facebook?
Yeah.
Unfriend you?
Amen.
Talk nasty things about you?
Yeah.
But guess what? The favor of God is still over your life.
Yes,
the anointing of God is over your life. Praise God. But the enemy had no harm. Joseph said, God, you turned it around for good. That I might save my family. God allowed Joseph to go through the pit. Not only that, he went through the prison, accused of messing with Pharaoh's, Potiphar's wife, but he got thrown in prison unjustly. But God took him from the pit to the prison to the palace.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And now the famine has come to Egypt. He's in Egypt now. His brothers come. He didn't know. They didn't even recognize Joseph. Because the favor of God is on you. When the favor of God is on you, when the anointing is on your life, sometimes even people that you grew up with won't recognize you.
Right. Yeah.
They want to keep you in a box. They want to keep you in an area that they're familiar with.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you don't let nobody stop the destiny that God has in your life. So we find in Genesis 47, let's see, let's go to verse 23. Genesis 47, 23.
Hallelujah.
All right. This is powerful here. Genesis 47, 23. I'm almost there, so hang tight. Then Joseph said to the people, indeed, I have brought you in your land this day for Pharaoh. Look, here is seed for you, and you shall sow the land, and it shall come to pass in the harvest time that you shall give one-fifth to Pharaoh. Four-fifths shall be yours, and the seed for the field, and for your food, for those of your households, and as food for your little ones. And they said, you have saved our lives. Let us find favor in the sight of my Lord, and we will be Pharaoh's servant. And Joseph made it a vow, or a law, over the land of Egypt to this day, that Pharaoh should have 1/5, that's 20% by the way, except for the land of the priest only, which did not become Pharaoh's. All right, let me tell you what's happened. The people were in lack. They didn't have no more food in Egypt. And they wanted to leave because there was no food, no substance in Egypt. And they were going to leave their land. But God told them through Pharaoh, all right, you can go. We'll provide food for you. But you got to give us 20%. 20% must go back to Pharaoh. 20% must go back to the government. In other words, the government's going to help you right now. We're going to help you. We're going to be a blessing to you and your family. And you can go back to the cities where there's food, where there's sustenance. But don't forget, write it on the contract. 20% goes to Pharaoh. 1/5, that's 20%. Isn't that amazing? God only asked for 10%. But Uncle Sam takes 20%.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
And we don't even have a choice with Uncle Sam.
Yeah.
He takes it anyway.
Yeah.
God says, return. Make it your choice. Return voluntarily. The 10%. So he gave them, they said, fine, we don't need our land right now because our land's not provided. And then he said, the rest of the 80% is yours. 80% is still yours. But if we're going to help you and we're going to bless you, then you must give us 20% to the government, to Pharaoh, and be his servant. You saved our lives. Thank you. Because we didn't have no sustenance. They were able, Joseph and the people of Egypt were able to give them food in another place, in another city that they had stored up, that they were going to give to them, provided they gave them 20% back so they wouldn't lose out. Here's the point. You need to sow to people first and foremost. Be a blessing first and foremost to people that are in your sphere of influence. Bless people that you know, first of all. It's good to help anyone. God will bless you if you help anyone, regardless if you know them or not. But there's something about helping people in your own clan, in your own family, in your own home. Oh, I'm telling you. And you might be a blessing to your family, and they don't appreciate it.
Yeah.
The people you love the most may not even reciprocate that back to you.
Yeah. Yes.
But guess what? You're going to overtake the reaper.
Amen. That's right.
You're going to overtake the harvest.
Yeah.
They might think that they got the upper hand.
Yeah.
Because you paid their car note.
Yeah.
Because you gave them housing. Because you let them stay in with you, and they didn't give you nothing.
Yeah.
They think they won.
Yeah.
I got her. I got him.
Mm-hmm.
I got my mom. I got my dad. Yeah. They're paying for my bills.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-mm. They didn't win.
Right.
I said they didn't win.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
Because eventually, it's going to come back to you.
That's right.
You're going to be blessed and overflowing. Joseph was so blessed, he could give food away.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to get so blessed, people of God.
That's right.
That there's going to be so much in your storehouse, you're not even going to miss it when you give it away.
Amen.
You're not even going to miss it when you sow it. Praise God. But here's the principle. Bless those that you know, first of all. Don't ignore your family.
No.
Don't ignore the people in your church.
Right.
Don't ignore the people. You know, that's why the Lord put it in my heart and my wife to just take things that we can't get rid of at the church.
Yeah.
That we had to downsize our place where we had some storage. And so we're in transition right now, but we're believing God for a bigger and a better place. Right. We're going to be a blessing to the children and our youth, meetings, all the things. I even see us having a fellowship hall, a brand new fellowship hall. And so we can have fellowship, we can have food, and it's going to be awesome.
That's right, yeah.
But every seed that we've ever planted, this ministry, God says, I remember that.
Yeah.
I remember that.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
And you didn't get recognized for it. You didn't get a pat on the back. You didn't get somebody giving you back in gratefulness and gratitude. Mm-hmm. But guess what? God knows what you did.
Amen.
And he's going to bless you.
Amen.
So sow to people that even you know that they appreciate you.
Amen.
Don't worry about it. God will bless you.
Yes, yes.
And then finally,
amen.
Things that I've learned about sowing is we sow where we want to go.
All right, now. Amen.
I say we sow where we want to go.
That's good, Pastor.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
My last scripture for tonight will be 2 Corinthians 9. 2 Corinthians 9, 6 and 7. 2 Corinthians chapter 9.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, G. Are we learning something tonight, church?
Amen.
It's a good word tonight.
Amen.
2 Corinthians 9, verse 6 and verse 7. And as I said, these will be my last two verses for tonight. But this I say, Paul writing to the church at Corinth, but this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. In other words, if you sow a little, you get a little. And he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So you know what that tells me? Our harvest, our rewards in life are not based upon God. It's based upon our level of sowing.
That's right.
It's based upon how we give. That's why sometimes we say, God, why are you blessing her, but you're not blessing me? Or yeah, you got to look at their level of sowing.
Amen.
You got to look at what they've given to God.
Mm-hmm.
See? Let me read it again. He who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. He who sows bountifully will reap bountifully. So let each one give or sow as he purposes in his heart. Not grudgingly, nor necessity, but God loves a cheerful giver.
Amen.
God loves a cheerful giver.
Amen.
Now what that tells me is that God's looking at our attitude when we give.
Yeah.
Not just what we give, but how we give.
Yes.
So we sow where we want to go. If you want... If you have big dreams, you have big seed.
Right now.
If you don't really believe God for much, Lord, here's my 10, here's my 5, here's my 20. But if you're believing God for something big,
amen,
you stretch your giving.
Right. Yes.
I can never complain about my harvest. I can never complain about what God and believing God wants to give me if I'm just throwing little seed. Now, I might start like that,
right,
but I don't end like that. I keep growing.
Amen, yes.
Try it. Test your level of giving. Wherever you're at, I don't know. I don't look at the tithe report at this church until the very end of the year, most of the time. Every now and then, we got one of those uncommon offerings. My wife tells me, I say, "Woo, thank you, Jesus."
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
But most of the time, I don't look at that. I don't want to be distracted with money. Because I learned in Bible school, our professor Cook used to tell us, students don't ever go to the ministry for noses, nickels, and numbers.
All right,
yeah. Yeah.
Unfortunately, I've been surrounded with people that are in it for noses, nickels, and numbers.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
But that's not my heart.
Amen.
So I don't even look at the finances till the end of the year when I have to sign the report that you, whatever you gave. Let me challenge you tonight. Stretch your giving. Not for my sake, for your sake.
Yes, yes.
I started stretching my giving when I first got my first job in Dallas, Texas. I knew I was supposed to tithe. I kept hearing the message all the time from my church. And so I said, Lord, I told the Lord, if you ever put seed in my hand, you give me a job, a good job, I promise. I make a vow to you, Lord. A-E-I-O-U. No, not that kind of vow. I make a vow that I'll give my 10% my first paycheck. Not only that, I make a vow that I'll take my family out to eat as a way of thank you for taking care of me all these years.
Yeah.
And I got my first paycheck working at Baylor Medical Center in Dallas, Texas. And I got my first check in 2 weeks. And I said, Mom and Dad, I think Sandra, my oldest sister, was there. She's with the Lord now. And I said, I want y'all to get ready because I'm going to take y'all out to eat.
Hallelujah.
And it's on me.
Amen.
What happened? I got paid. How many of some people get paid? They don't want to talk. They don't want to talk to you. I know some people that they get paid. Where'd they go? Oh, it was payday. Forgot about all your good deeds. Forgot about you taking them to work. Forgot about you ironing their shirt. Forgot about you washing their clothes. Picking up McDonald's when you didn't have no money. And they got a check. And they got their pay check, and you don't know where they're at.
All right.
Yeah.
I paid for my family that day. Payment was on me. It was just my way of saying thank you, Mom. Thank you for cleaning my poop when I was a little boy.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dad.
Yeah.
For taking me to work.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Amen.
And then I said, I'm going to give to my church. And at that time, the economy was different, obviously. I think I got something like $300 or something that 2 weeks. But the Lord told me in my heart, you know, you don't have to give exactly the 10%. And I started rebuking that. That must be the devil talking to me. And so I rounded up. Some of y'all round y'all tied down, but I rounded up.
All right, right.
And I said, God, you're getting $50. Mm-hmm. My first tithe that I ever gave was $50. Mm-hmm. And it should have been technically 10%, 33, 34, 35, whatever I got paid, 360. Mm-hmm. Should have been 36. See, I'm not telling you something that I don't practice myself.
Right. Yeah.
If you're having a hard time giving that, you are failing to realize your harvest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You are failing to realize that God has a land over here that flows with milk and honey.
Amen.
We've had very generous givers in this church.
Yes.
And you know, that didn't happen by accident because we started with $50.
Amen.
My wife and I, when we left our last church, to God be the glory, not only did we cried. I remember that time. We cried. And they laid hands on us. Oh, we don't want to leave our church. We don't want to leave. But we cried. But not only did we cry, our pastors cried. Because we were in the top two tithe givers. Come on, somebody. And God had just been so generous and so gracious to us.
Amen.
I'm not telling you so we can get your money.
Right.
Livingstone Family Church doesn't want your money. Dracula wants your money. Chocula, what's that too? I love it. I found some at home in the days. They bought it. They were trying to hide it from me. Can you believe that? I'm just kidding. I found it though. But I got to be careful.
Yes, sir.
We sow where we go.
Yes.
I said to myself, you know why I gave $50? My first tithe, $50. You know why I did that? And just didn't give the minimum? Because I said, I want to make at least $500 every week, every 2 weeks. I want to tithe on what I'm going to be making. I want to tithe on credit. I'm going to tithe. So if I tithe $100, I'm believing I'm going to get $1,000. Come on, somebody. I'm going to tithe what I believe I'm going to be making.
Amen.
Stretch your faith.
Yes.
You always want to just be making what you're making. Too much that we need. I don't know about you. I need more than $100.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah. So I get, and this is what we do. I'm going to close with this. I was wondering, how am I going to close this study? This is how I'm going to close it. I'm going to tell you what my wife and I do. So we sow where we go. Sow into the place that you want to be at. We sow where we want to go.
Amen.
So let's review. I'm going to give my little testimony. We sow, number one, can we put it back on the screen, please? We sow to grow. No other way. There's no shortcuts in the kingdom of God.
Mm-hmm.
You can't live off of somebody else's faith.
That's right.
Your faith must be personal.
Mm-hmm.
When you sow, you're going to start growing. Number two, you sow when the circumstances say, no, I better not. Better hold it. Better keep it in my pocket.
Hmm.
Like I told you earlier, if it doesn't meet your need, it's a seed.
Yes.
If you can't pay what you got to pay this week, that light bill, that car note, then give it to the house of God. Why? Because it's not going to make a difference either way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You might as well sow it and let God do something with that.
Yes.
Amen.
Because it ain't working the way you're doing it.
Yeah.
It doesn't work the way I do it. Lean not to your own understanding.
Yeah.
But in all thy ways acknowledge him and he will direct your path.
Yes.
And then thirdly, we sow to who we know. Pay attention to the people in your world. You're not called to help everybody. Maybe you can at times help a stranger. Maybe you can at times help somebody you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But for the most part, those people that are in your life right now,
mm-hmm.
they're in your life for a reason.
Yes.
My mom and my dad that day when I got paid, I said, you're going to get blessed because I know you. I'm your son.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm your son. I need to take care of you.
Mm-hmm.
I need to bless my mom. Listen, if you're a son and you're a daughter and you can't bless your mom and dad, something's wrong with you.
Yeah. Yes, amen.
If you have it.
Sorry.
If you have it in your hands, I understand. You don't have it, that's different. But when you got it, and you can do a blessing for your mom and your dad, and you don't do it, something's wrong with you.
Mm-hmm.
That's your mom.
Yeah.
That's your dad.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And then we sow where we want to go. We sow to the direction of our faith, to the direction of our destiny. I was sowing $50 because I wanted to be making $500, not $300.
Amen.
You see that? I took a step of faith. Mm. And I did eventually make that. So here's my final story. Did y'all get something here tonight for me? For those of you who think I'm just talking about money, you missed the message. It's not about money.
Yeah.
God loves a cheerful giver. It's about your heart.
Yes.
God loves a cheerful giver. He says, you want to sow little? That's up to you. But don't complain about little results. But if you want to stretch your faith, then sow bountifully. Sow in faith to the direction that you want to go.
Mm-hmm.
And see what God can do.
Amen.
Yep.
So every 2 weeks, when my wife and I get paid, direct deposit, the first thing that we do is we automatically give our tithe and our offering, and we transfer it to our church account. No ands, ifs, and buts about it. We don't think about it. We don't say, wow, got to pay that light bill this week. I may not have it this week. We don't second guess it. No doubt, if another bill has to wait, it's going to wait. But God's getting his tithe.
Yeah.
And we transfer it automatically to the church account. Because we want the church account to be full.
Yes.
Yes.
We want our church to be full.
Amen.
We want our church to be healthy.
Amen.
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 And that's how we pay what we pay. Because we tithe, we give. I'm not telling you something I don't practice. We've been doing it for many, many, many years. So tonight, challenge your faith. Keep sowing.
Amen.
Don't give up. You're going to catch up. You're going to catch up to people that are already in their dream home. You're going to catch up to people that are already married. We got any young people want to get married? Okay. Maybe nobody? Okay. You may be looking at a beautiful couple and man, they must have it together. Keep sowing. Keep sowing.
Man.
That's what I did. I just kept sowing when I was single. I just kept sowing. I believe one of the reasons why I got married, I don't can't speak for my wife, but I know one of the reasons why I got married is because I was living such a carefree life that I didn't need to be married. I was having just a wonderful time. I was 28 years old when I got married. I was in no rush. I was serving the Lord in the ministry, and my wife laughs about it. It's true. But there were women in line to date me. No, I'm just kidding. Praise God. Y'all laughing? Why y'all laughing at that? Amen. Let's stand to our feet, everybody. Praise God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
My wife laughs at me. But anyway, did y'all get something from the Lord tonight?
Amen.
Thank you, sir.
Amen. Thank you.
Sowing will always give you the victory.
Yes. Yes, it will.
I want y'all, before Sunday comes, ask the Lord, Lord, what can I sow? How can I be a blessing? How can I help somebody? I know even today, someone did something nice to me today. A coworker did something nice to me today. I was going to get off close to 6 o'clock today because we just had someone that I had to pick up that was taking forever. That's all I got to say about that. They were taking forever. And I didn't think fighting the traffic on 90, I didn't think I was going to get back home till about 6. But a coworker said, hey, Mark, I'll go ahead and pick that person up. Mm-hmm. I said, wait a minute. I said, no, I'm scheduled to do it. I don't want you to do it. No. I'll go ahead and do it. And I said, wow. I told the Lord, thank
Amen.
You, Lord.
Amen.
I said, I got off at 4:30. Could have been easily 6. Could have easily been 5:30. Mm-hmm. But you see, somebody sowed that good seed.
Man.
Doesn't that make you feel good?
That's good.
When you do something good for someone.
Yes.
And
yes.
You bless them.
Amen.
All right. Well, I want to pray for you tonight. And Brother Jay, you can go ahead and that's Brother Jay, man. All my boys are Brother Jay. All right. Jeremiah, Joshua, and Jamin. Mm-hmm. But I want y'all to bow your heads with me real quick. And we're going to be dismissed in just a few moments. Every head bowed and every eye closed tonight. If you receive something from the Lord tonight, then I want you to just raise that right hand to God as a sign of surrender, as a sign of yieldingness to God. Oh, yes. Beautiful song. Thank you, Jesus. He loves us like a hurricane. Thank you, God. Let's just worship Him a few moments. I was going to pray, and I am. But can we just worship the Lord with this song for just a few moments? Because God loves us tonight. Go ahead and turn it up a little bit, Brother Jim.
I'm unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory.
Thank you, God.
And I realize just how beautiful you are now. Great your affections are for me.
Oh, how He loves us. How He loves us tonight.
How He loves us.
Cheerful giver. Hallelujah.
loves us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh,
he loves us. He loves us tonight. I want y'all to do something before we go home. I want you to get both of your hands out, put it in front of you, like a cup, getting ready to receive something. Just go ahead and just put that hand, those hands together. And I want you to say after me. Say, Lord, I love you. And as my hands are open, I ask you, God, to fill me. Give me seed in my heart and my hands to be a blessing to somebody. I thank you, Lord, that you love a cheerful giver. And I make a vow to you, Lord, that if you put seed in my hand, I will give it to you, Lord. And I will help others. All those that you need me to. Because
I know God.
I can never outgive God.
Thank you, Lord, for loving me.
And blessing me tonight.
Help me never ever.
To forget this word.
That I'm
going to
grow
by sowing. That I'm not going to look at my circumstances.
I'm going to keep sowing.
And I'm going to bless those
that are in my life.
And I'm going to sow
to where I
want to
go.
And
my future.
And my destiny. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And amen. Praise God. Isn't that good? Well, I trust and pray that you got something from the Lord tonight,
amen.
This Wednesday night.
Glory to God.
Don't forget, we're still doing our prayer time before Sunday morning at 9:15. If you can't join us at 9:15, join us at 9:20,
yes.
9:30.
Amen. Yes.
But push yourself,
yes.
Because we need your support,
yes.
Also in prayer.
Yes. Yes.
Invite somebody to come this Sunday, and hopefully by this weekend, you're going to see, pulling up over here on Frontier Tribe, you're going to see that banner.
Right.
It's going to say something like free event, free family event.
Amen.
And we're believing that we're going to make a difference in someone's life.
Amen.
Amen. And so I want to thank y'all for helping us with that $60 sign. We didn't even ask for your money, but if you gave something tonight, you're helping us with that cause. Amen. If you gave your offering tonight, let me tell you something. If you gave your offering, you're going to help us with that banner. So thank you so much. We love y'all.
Yes.
Y'all have a great time. We still have a couple of things, right, Joanna? A few little items in the back. Just get with my wife. Make sure that they're clear to take. That we're trying to just get rid of. We're just trying to sow it. We're just trying to give it away. You can look in the back after church, and you can get whatever you need. Remember,
God loves you.
We love you.
And Jesus is Lord.
God bless.